In today's video, I'll be discussing how to determine the empirical and molecular formulas from experimental data. Our objective is to determine empirical formulas from elemental analysis data and molecular formulas from molar mass data. You may want to go back and watch the video about distinguishing the difference between empirical and molecular formulas if you haven't watched it already. To remind you, we can determine the molecular formula of a compound by identifying the number of atoms of each type in that molecule. In glucose, you'll see that there are 6 carbon, 12 hydrogen, and 6 oxygen atoms in one glucose molecule. This is called the molecular formula because it represents the actual composition of that molecule. The empirical formula is the lowest whole number ratio of atoms in a compound. In the case of glucose, its empirical formula is CH2O. This is because the molecular formula can be divided by 6, a common denominator, to give 1 carbon to 2 hydrogens to 1 oxygen, and that's the empirical formula. One of the motivations for this learning objective is that chemists are often asked to identify unknown molecules using experimental techniques. You might think if you're given an unknown molecule, you could just determine its molar mass. And indeed, this is one type of analysis that we can do. However, there are multiple compounds with the same or very similar molar mass values. Here is just one example of the molecule caffeine having essentially the same molar mass as a molecule found in plant cell walls. So just because we can determine the molar mass doesn't mean we can actually identify what the molecule is. What we really need here is a technique that can tell us the amount of different elements in a compound and what they are. This technique is called elemental analysis. What elemental analysis is essentially burning a compound and measuring the amount of constituent elements using different detectors. Here's a laboratory setup shown on the left and a schematic shown on the right of how elemental analysis works. We won't go into too many details here, but what you need to know is the data that are obtained from elemental analysis include mass percentage data of different elements in the compound. Let's look at an example. The analysis of the exhaust gases from motor traffic reveals the presence of a carcinogenic substance. Elemental analysis reveals that the substance contains 92.3% carbon and 7.74% hydrogen. These are elemental analysis data, percent of each element in the compound by mass. What's being asked here is to find the compound's empirical formula. What we're given are the elemental analysis results, and we need the empirical formula. Our strategy to find the empirical formula will be to take our percent mass data, convert to grams, grams to moles, divide by small, multiply till whole. This is kind of a little empirical formula poem you can jot down in your notes. Let's solve it with respect to this specific problem. The first step is percent in grams. So if we have a 100 gram sample, so that's a big assumption here, if we have a 100 gram sample of our unknown, we know from our elemental analysis that this will result in 92.3 grams of carbon and 7.75 grams of hydrogen. Again, this is taking our elemental analysis results in percentage and converting to grams, assuming a 100 gram sample. Now, you could assume some other mass total, such as 1,000 grams or 200 grams, but by choosing 100 grams, it helps us to simplify the math and easily adapt these percentage values to mass. The next step is grams to moles. So we have our two values of our two elements in grams, and now we need to convert them to moles. You should be very familiar with this skill, and what we need to do is use the molar mass of each element to convert 12.01 grams per 1 mole of carbon and 1.01 grams per 1 mole of hydrogen. Let's make sure we have our hydrogens and carbons in here. So grams of carbon cancels with grams. Grams of hydrogen cancels with grams. And we're left with moles of carbon in the top calculation. And when I did this, I got 7.69 moles of carbon. And in the bottom, I got 7.67 moles of hydrogen. Now we need to divide by small. What this means is identifying which mole value is the smallest. In this case, it's 7.67. So we're going to divide all values, all mole values, by 7.67. Now when I do this for hydrogen, I end up getting 1 mole of hydrogen. When I do this for carbon, I end up getting a value that's approximately 1 within rounding. And this is important, because if we're in within, let's just say, you know, if we're within 0.98 or 0.01, we can effectively round up or down accordingly. So here we got a value that's essentially 1, and here we got a value of 1. What this tells us is the mole ratio of carbon to hydrogen, C1H1. Simplified, how we would normally write our empirical formula would be CH. Now this has a mass of 13.0 grams per mole. I'm just noting that here so that you can remember it for the next part of this problem. In this case, we've solved the problem. CH is the empirical formula of our unknown carcinogen. Now, this doesn't mean we've found the identity of the carcinogen yet. For that, we need to use molar mass data coupled with our empirical formula. We can use a technique called mass spectrometry to determine the molar mass of an unknown. You don't need to know anything about this technique for now. Just know that the result is the molar mass. Once we have the molar mass, we can compare the empirical formula mass to the molar mass to determine the molecular formula. This will probably sound familiar from the distinguishing between empirical and molecular formulas video that hopefully you've already watched. If we're given some additional information about this problem, we can see that the mass spectral data of our unknown exhaust carcinogen was used to determine the molar mass as 78.1 grams per mole. Let's find the carcinogen's molecular formula. What we need to do is we need to divide the molecular formula, molar mass, 78.1 grams per mole, by the mass of the empirical formula. And that was what I had shown on the previous slide of empirical formula. When I calculate this value, I get a number 6. What that tells us is the molecular formula is 6 times, oops, sorry about that, 6 times the empirical formula. We know the empirical formula from the last part is CH. Now, if we multiply this by 6, this gives us a value of, or a formula of H6. This is the actual identity of our unknown molecule, which is hexacarbon hexahydride, otherwise known as benzene. This is the molecular formula of benzene. The empirical formula is CH. Let's do a more complex example if you're ready for the next step. We have a mystery substance found in somebody's kitchen. The substance's elemental analysis results are shown here. You'll notice that this substance contains carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, and oxygen. We know the molar mass of the compound from some presumably mass spectroscopy data, and what we're trying to find is the unknown compound's molecular formula. Let's be organized about this, starting with our carbon. Then we have hydrogen, nitrogen, and oxygen. So we're going to use our empirical formula POEM, percent to mass, mass to moles, divide by small, multiply till whole, to solve this problem. First step, percent in grams. Oops, and I think I actually have that there. We're just going to move our carbon down a little bit. All right. So we're going to start with our percentage data in grams. Convert that by assuming a 100-gram sample, 57.1 grams of carbon, 6.16 grams of hydrogen, 9.52 grams of nitrogen, and 27.18 grams of oxygen. Convert to moles. This will be done using each substance's molar mass for carbon. I get 4.7 moles. For hydrogen, I get 6.10 moles. For nitrogen, we haven't used nitrogen yet in this video, but its molar mass is 14.01 grams per 1 mole. And nitrogen, I got 0.80 moles. Oh, I should be labeling these, of course, hydrogen. Carbon. It can be very confusing if we don't use appropriate units because we can easily get lost in these kinds of long problems. For oxygen, and here I got 1.70 moles of oxygen. So this was the second step, grams to moles. The next step is divide by small. You'll notice here that the nitrogen value in moles is the smallest number. So I'm going to divide everything by 0.680. Sorry, this is getting a little messy, but bear with me. 0.680. When I do that, I get 7 moles of carbon. Actually, when I calculated this value for hydrogen, I got 8.97. Now, 8.97 essentially rounds to 9. It's quite close, right? It's like within 0.03 of 9. So we're going to count that as essentially equal to 9 moles of hydrogen. When I calculated for nitrogen, obviously dividing by the smallest with the same value gives us a value of 1. And for oxygen, I got 2.5. Now, if I was to write my empirical formula from this information, I would have C7H9N with an implied 1, which I don't need to write, and O2.5. So I want you to think to yourself, is that possibly an empirical formula? Hopefully you're saying the answer is no, because this is not the smallest whole number ratio of atoms in the compound. You'll notice 2.5 is not a whole number. So what do I need to do? I need to follow the last step of the empirical formula, multiply till whole. So if I take this formula and multiply it by 2, what that gives me is C14H9. 9 here times 2 is 18. Nitrogen is going to be N2. And oxygen, 2.5 times 2 is 5. Now, this is the empirical formula for our compound. To find, and the reason for that is because it's the lowest whole number ratio. To find the molecular formula, which is what we're asked in this problem, we should calculate the mass of the empirical formula. When I calculated the mass of the empirical formula using values on the periodic table, right? The mass of carbon times 14 plus the mass of hydrogen times 18, etc. I actually got a value of around 294 grams per mole. What this means is the empirical formula is the same as the molecular formula because the mass of the empirical formula is the same as the molar mass of the compound. Therefore, the empirical formula is the same as the molecular formula. In this video, I've provided a couple of different examples of how to determine the empirical formula from elemental analysis data and molecular formulas if you're given the molar mass. Here's a handy flowchart that you can use to remember the empirical formula poem. Percent to mass, mass to moles, divide by small, multiply to the whole. I hope you found this video to be helpful, and good luck practicing this objective on your own. See you in the next video.